Hello everyone, I am going to explain question number 1 from exercise 2.3 of class 10th maths. So the question first is, prove that 5 minus root 3 is an irrational number. So before doing this question, first it should be very clear that what are irrational numbers. And before doing the irrational number, first we'll understand what is rational numbers. So rational numbers are the numbers which we can write in the form of P upon Q. So rational numbers are the numbers which we can write in the form of numerator and denominator, where denominator cannot be equal to 0. So all are rational numbers, like 3 upon 5 and 7 upon 8, all these are 9 upon 3, all these are rational numbers. Even we can say that 4 is also rational number. Why? Because 4 also we can write as numerator upon denominator, like 8 upon 2. It's a in the form of P upon Q, but its answer is 4. So all the numbers which we know, all are rational numbers. Then what are irrational numbers? So irrational numbers are just opposite of rational numbers. Rational numbers which we can write in the form of P upon Q. So opposite of it is which we cannot write in the form of P upon Q. So irrational numbers are the numbers, irrational numbers are the numbers which we cannot means not equal to P upon Q, which we cannot write in the form of numerator upon denominator. Then what are the irrational numbers? So irrational numbers we'll obtain when we'll do the square root of prime numbers. Prime numbers means the numbers which is divisible by itself, which cannot be divisible by any other number, like 2 is also prime number, and 3 is also prime number, 5 is also prime number. So if we'll find out the square root of prime numbers, all these are going to be the irrational numbers. So what are the irrational numbers? Irrational numbers are the numbers which we cannot write in the form of P upon Q. Now what are the irrational numbers which we know? That is square root of prime numbers, like root 2, root 3, root 5, root 11, root 17. So all these are prime numbers, and just write down the square root of prime number, that will convert to the irrational number. So it should be very clear, the irrational number we cannot write in the form of P upon Q. Okay, now we'll move to the question. I hope now it's clear to you what do you mean by irrational number. Irrational number means which we cannot write in the form of numerator upon denominator. Now here we concentrate on our number. The number is 5 minus root 3. So here 5 is rational number and root 3 is irrational number. So if we subtract root 3 from 5, the complete result is going to be irrational, that we have to prove. So these kind of questions we will prove by the contradiction method. Contradiction method means contradict. Contradict means just opposite. What they want to prove, just opposite of that we are going to assume. So we'll assume that 5 minus root 3 is rational. So just opposite of that we have to assume. So that is named as contradiction method. So we'll write here, let 5 minus root 3 is a rational number. And if it is a rational number, so what is the definition of rational number? Which we can write in the form of P upon Q. So if it is a rational number, the conclusion is we can write 5 minus root 3 in the form of numerator upon denominator. So that I am assuming as A upon B, where the denominator cannot be equal to 0. And here what are A and B? And here A and B are co-prime integrals. Integrals means integers. So So now we have to understand the coprime meaning also. Coprime means which don't have any common factor. Like suppose students, I just want to explain the coprime numbers. Suppose we are writing here 12 upon 15. These two are not coprime because these two we can cancel by 3. 3 4s are 12 and 3 5s are 15 and 4 upon 5. So just see, initially we had 12 upon 15 and after cancellation we obtained 4 upon 5. So this 4 upon 5 further we cannot cancel. Why? Because they don't have any common factor. That's why these are named as coprime numbers. So coprime numbers means which we cannot cancel, which don't have any common factor. So I hope it's clear to you. I mean, after all the cancellation, simplification, whatever answer will come, that is named as coprime numbers. Means here A and B, we cannot cancel by any number. They are in their simplest form. That's why they are named as coprime integral. So this is a language-based question. Statement are very necessary. So you should understand all the statements because complete exercise will go on the step-by-step on the same way. How I will do question number one in the same way. So just understand properly. Now this equation we are going to assume as equation first. Now here the next step. So I hope this is your first step is clear to you. What is our first step? Whatever be the question, that question we have to assume as rational number. Rational numbers means which we can write in the form of numerator upon denominator. So assume any alphabet like L, M, N, anything you just assume here. And where denominator should not be zero. Why it should not be 0? Because if it's going to be 0, then it will convert to the infinity not defined. And it should not be not defined, it should be well defined. That's why B not equal to 0. And there is a one restriction, one boundation for A and B. A and B are coprime integrals. Integrals means integers. Now, here, coprime integers means I already explained here, which is in the simplest form, which we cannot cancel further. Now step second. In step second, whatever be the irrational number, that we have to separate with positive symbol. So root 3 I am shifting here, and A minus A and B I am shifting here. So after all the shifting, this 5 at its own place, when I will shift this A plus B, A upon B in this side, since it has plus sign, so when I will shift here, it is going to be in the minus sign, minus A upon B. And when I will shift this root 3 in the other side, it has minus sign, so it will change to root 3. Now here I am going to take the LCM. So when I will take the LCM, okay, nothing is there, so 1. So LCM of 1 and B is B. Now B divided by 1 is B. So after LCM, here what answer will come? B multiplied by 5. Now how I obtained here? B divided by 1 is B. Then multiplied by 5. Then minus as it is. Now B divided by B is 1 and multiplied by this A and is equal to root 3. Now here after all the simplification we will obtain its 5, B into 5 is 5B, A into 1 is A upon B is equal to root 3. So in our left hand side, first we will write down like this here. In left hand side A, B, 5, whatever be the varieties of numbers you have, so you have A, then you have B and then you have 5 are integers because these are the integers, and if these are the integers so 5B minus A upon B is, because it is in the form of numerator upon denominator, so it's a rational number. So we write here, so 5b minus a upon b is a rational number. And if it's left hand side is a rational number, so in left hand side a, b, 5 are integers, so 5b minus a upon b is a rational number. So root 3 is also a rational number because here it's a left hand side and it's a right hand side. So if left hand side is rational number, then right hand side is also rational number. But what we know that root 3 is, I already explained here, root 3 is irrational number. So here we'll write down, but we know that, root 3 is an irrational number. Now here we are concluding that it's a rational number and here we are writing that it's irrational number. So this is contradicting each other. Now why this contradiction has arisen? Because we started wrong. So because we started by assuming it's rational, so this contradiction has arisen. So we'll write here, this contradiction has arisen. This contradiction has arisen because of our wrong assumption. So again I am repeating how we had concluded it. First I concluded that the left hand side is a rational number. Why I concluded it is rational number? Because a, b and 5 are integers. So if you divide numerator and denominator, since it is in the form of p upon q, so it's rational. And if left hand side is rational, then right hand side is also rational. So here we are concluding that root 3 is a rational number, but we already know that the root 3 is not rational, it's irrational because it's a prime number. So square root of prime number is irrational. So these both statements are just opposite of each other. Here we are concluding that it's rational, but we are writing here it's irrational. So this is contradict to each other, means opposite to each other. And so that you have to write down. This contradiction has arisen because of our wrong assumption. Now why we got the opposite result? Because we started wrongly. What mistake we had done here? We assumed it's rational. So this is our mistake. So we have to correct it. So instead of rational number, what answer will come here? Irrational. So here we write down. This proves that. Now we are going to, whatever be the wrong assumption, that we are going to correct here. So this proves that. This proves that 5 minus root 3 is an irrational number, and that only we require to prove. So finally, hence prove. I hope it's clear to you. So how we have, there are three steps, friends. First step, you have to just assume it's opposite. They want to prove it's irrational. Just assume it as rational. And if it is rational, you can write in the form of numerator upon denominator. Then in second step, separate the root symbol alone. And after separating the root symbol alone, whatever be the left hand side or right hand side, you just prove that it's a rational number by proving it as a numerator upon denominator. That's why it is a rational number. And if left hand side is rational, then right hand side is also rational. And after writing it, so this we had done because of our calculation, we obtained that root 3 is rational, but we know that root 3 is irrational, and this both lines are contradict to each other. And then finally just write down, this contradiction has arisen because of our wrong assumption. And after, since this assumption that is a rational number was wrong, if it is wrong, then what is correct? Correct statement is going to be, so instead of rational, if it is not rational, then it has only one option, it's going to be irrational. So we'll write here finally irrational. That's it. So like this, in complete exercise, further questions also we are going to do on pattern of this first question. So understand it properly. This complete exercise is theoretical. I hope it's clear to you. Further, if you have doubt, you can write in comments so that I can clear up your doubts. Thank you.